You're not going to believe how much easier this makes downloading images in SharePoint. Check out this amazing solution I found on the Microsoft 365 Community GitHub repo. It allows faster downloads, it looks great, and it will really help your users out, even you. I hate how long it takes to download files sometimes in SharePoint. There's just too many clicks, and I don't have time for that. This thing puts a big old button right on the screen. One click, one download. It's that simple. Now, this solution is not going to work for you if you just follow the instructions on the solution page. There's something important you've got to do on this list. I've already submitted this pull request so that the documentation gets updated and that everyone has a working solution when they try and build this thing out. Watch until the end. I will cover that important change. But first, let's build this thing out and see how it works. Now, this solution is created by Ganesh Sanap. Sorry if I mispronounced that name, but it's a great solution. It's going to take a list that has an image column, and it's going to format a new column to provide a download button. So with one click, you can download that particular image. Now, this is suited for a list that has an image column, but I would certainly think you can get this to work on a library too. Try that out and let me know how it turns out for you. What's also kind of exciting is this comments count column over here. I think that's another solution that this person made. I have seen that in the samples library. Let me know down in the comments if you want to see this solution demoed as well. So to get started, we can check out the view requirements, and this just needs an image column. It needs to be called image. That's what the internal name here means, is that when you initially create that column, it has to be called image. You could rename it to whatever you want after the fact, because the internal name will still stay the same. So keep that in mind. It doesn't have to be a required column, but think about it. If you don't have an image, you're not going to be able to download it. So maybe it should be required. It would make more sense if it were. But back to this list. So I'm on my list. It's really just a collection of some of my wallpapers that I use. And the first thing we need to do is add a column where this button is going to live. Now, the column can really be called anything. And we're not going to store any data in here. I'm just going to call this download. You can call it action or something like that. Anything will work, really. So we'll save this. We're not going to have any data in this. All we're going to do is format this column, go straight to advanced mode like we always do. And then we're going to go into this JSON file. And the link for this solution is going to be down in the description below. But let's jump straight to the JSON. As you see, there's really not a lot here. And we'll cover this whole thing so you know how it works. But for now, I'm just going to copy this, go back into our JSON editor, and paste it in. Let's save this. And we've got a download button for every image now. Very cool. Let's click on this and try it out. It downloads it. Very, very easy. I love this thing. Now, as I mentioned, this is not going to work straight out of the box without one crucial change. But before we get to that, let's just talk for a second about how this JSON is going to work. Now, you see at the top, according to the schema, we're using a column formatter. And that's a good thing because we did put it into a column. It's going to create one root element. It's going to be a button. We set some basic styles in here to cover the border radius. So you could increase that if you wanted a rounder button, or set it to 0 pixels if you want a square button. You got some options there for how it looks. Setting some margins on here, and then whether this button should be displayed or not. So you see the display property is using an expression, whether the image, this is why that image column must be called image, because it's referring to it right here. If you originally named that column something else, then you can update any reference you see here to image with this type of syntax to whatever you happen to call that column, and everything will still work. But we're gonna be checking to see if the image server relative URL is equal to a blank string. So that would essentially mean the image doesn't exist. There's no image for that particular list item. If that's the case, then display is set to none, which will hide this button. Otherwise, it leaves it as a blank string, which will show the button. Pretty simple, right? Here's the attributes object, which will set the current theme, the primary theme on this button. So if somebody updates this site and changes the theme, kind of changes some colors around a little bit, well, if the button happened to have a new color, this will automatically pick up that new color. So that's a great thing. And then inside this button, we're going to be creating a couple of elements. Here's an anchor element. So this is going to give you the hyperlink. Under the attributes, you'll see where the hyperlink is going to point to. The href is set to current web, which will be the current site URL. Oh, and by the way, if you are interested in learning a lot more about these things and some of these different special strings, as they're called, I've got an online course launching in about 2 weeks. So check the description below for the link to that course, and I'll see you there. But in the meantime, let's keep going through this solution. So we're going to be using the current site URL, current web. Then we're going to be adding in a special URL that's kind of baked into the site, one of the many different little system pages that can be used, like the download.aspx file. We're calling this particular file and we're passing in one parameter, source URL. And that's going to be the image server relative URL. This is the path to that image file itself. And if this download link is not working, it's because that this one setting is not set correctly. And we're about to get to that. But let's finish up the JSON walkthrough. We're setting target equal to blank, which will cause a new tab to open up. That is handy so that you don't kick someone out of the SharePoint page that they were just looking at, which, as you know, is quite irritating when you have to go back to the previous page. We're setting some more classes here under the attributes to control the font size and the font color. And then inside this anchor tag, we're going to be creating a span to house the actual text someone sees on that button. We're going to be using a span with an icon inside it. And the icon from Fluent UI is going to be download. That's going to give us this particular downward arrow that people would generally associate with a download. But just in case they don't, we also have the text right afterwards in another span with just the word download next to it. And that's it. That's really all there is to it. We've got a button, a link, an icon, and some basic text. And that's all it takes to get something like this to work. It's really cool. But speaking of working, here's the setting that you will need to change so that these images will work correctly. You'll need to go into less settings, into advanced settings, and then you're going to need to make sure attachments are disabled for this. If attachments are enabled, then those images in the image column are going to be stored in a different location in that list. When they're stored in a different location, then that server relative URL is not going to work. So if you put this in and that download button just doesn't work, it just takes you to a SharePoint page instead of actually downloading the file, then it's because this attachments has not been disabled. Now, once you do disable that, you're going to need to change the images. You'll need to re-upload them because SharePoint won't move those images to the normal spot where they need to be, where this download button is going to expect them to be, unless you re-upload those. So that's easy enough. You could just hop straight into Edit Grid View and change them right here. You can just hit the little trash can icon, re-upload those files, save it by exiting grid view, and then everything will work fine at that point. But keep that in mind, the attachments will need to be disabled for this to work correctly. I think this thing is brilliant. It's not only simple, but it also provides a great quality of life feature inside a list. And this thing pairs great with the image preview solution that I showed you quite a while back. If you want a refresher on how that works, so you could start thinking about how to best integrate these two solutions, then watch this video right here and get started creating.